So first email, we'll get right into it. And it says, I was a businessman and she is a banker. We've been married for 6 years with two kids. 3 years after marriage, my business collapsed, so feeding my family became difficult for me. My wife's attitude suddenly changed, you know, started changing us. She lost respect for me. She started cheating, didn't even apologize anytime I caught her cheating. She sometimes refers to me as a good-for-nothing man, just to mention a few. I've cried so many nights. Friends that I helped in the past have also turned their back on me. I was really going through hell on earth. Because of all this, I decided to travel to Saudi Arabia to seek greener pastures to enable me to take care of my family and to restore joy in my home. I stayed abroad for 1 year, but things were tough for me and I couldn't endure it anymore. So I called my wife and told her about the situation. She advised me to come home rather than to die there. When I returned to Ghana, she immediately packed her belongings and left with the kids to her mother's home. She said she would only return when I find my feet again. Jess, I was shattered. I'm in a dilemma now. I don't know what to do again because I've tried all I can so I can get a job to at least pay my kids' school fees. But nothing seems to be working for me. I'm all alone now and I have 2 more months to renew my rent, but I don't have any money. I feel like a disappointment to my family. I feel like committing suicide. Please help me. Now, obviously, this will be something really difficult to go through, to lose literally your wife and family because things aren't going well for you. Well, Tina, let me come straight to you since you're in the studio.
Okay, so I'm very sorry things have been this terrible with you. It's not a good place to be at right now. But what I can say is that sometimes you should just think and know that you may find yourself in situations that you feel all alone. I don't know if you're a Christian or you, it doesn't seem to me like you even have the friends or the family to support you. So you feel all alone. If you are a Christian or you believe you are in any faith, I think this is the time that you start talking to your God. You start associating with some people to talk to as an outlet. Just because you have mentioned that you want to commit suicide. Mm. When you get to that point, usually you are alone and you're confused and nothing seems to make sense. So having another person with you or having to see someone, I won't say a counselor because you probably need to pay some money. But if you don't have to pay some money and you go to church and you can find somebody who you know you can talk to, please do. Mm. Don't be alone in this time. Thank you for reaching out to us as well. Now, in terms of getting a job and everything, maybe what people normally look at is some big breakthrough, okay, that needs to come in. You need to get thousands of CDs before you realize that there's something coming in. Do you get it? Hmm. But I think whatever you can find that is very easy to do, please do it. If it brings 200 CDs, you can eat. Hmm. You can take care of your bill so that at least you don't have to depend on someone for your basic living needs. Then you can build on that to get some money. You can talk to people to borrow some money for the meantime. The thing is, you need something quick to stand on your feet. But whatever you're doing, don't see it as something that you have to get some major money before it's a breakthrough. I don't know if you get what I mean. You know, a lot of times people think that you need to get thousands of CDs before you are recognized as some kind of, but when the money is trickling in, the way you spend your expenses, the way you manage your money and everything, it will actually let you save or be able to take care of yourself. So that I think that now you need to take care of yourself. Before, if you're able to take care of yourself, then you, the next move is to take care of your family. Because right now, you can't even take care of your own self. So you're eating, you're feeding, you're living, your living expenses, rent, and all those things. That's the immediate thing you should be thinking about.
Right.
And now that you're also thinking about suicide, please find someone to talk to. You can reach out to us, like, after all, we can reach out to you and provide you with maybe a counselor or somebody.
Yeah.
Because it's a terrible place to find yourself.
It really is. Rosina, let me come to you. I mean, I don't know what you're going to say, but...
Yeah, what I wanted to say was that maybe a little bit of what Tina said, but most of the time, the fact that in his submission, he started by saying, my wife is a banker, I have a feeling that he wants a job that is commensurate to a woman banker so that he can feel like he's earning more than the woman, and sometimes it's an ego issue. So most of the time, when it comes to seeking jobs, when you are seeking for a job 1 month, 5 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, and you can't get a job, it's high time you look for your own kind of thing to get a job. And once whatever you're doing is legal and is profitable, I think that there should be no shame in that. Because most of the time, your ability to look after your family and yourself justifies the means. That's one side. The other side is that people have this mentality that if you can't get a white-collar job in Ghana to do, then traveling out is the best option. I'm wondering how much he spent to get a ticket, to survive in Saudi Arabia for a whole year. That money could easily be channeled into some entrepreneurial activity in Ghana to survive. If not to pay for rent and big, big deals, at least to pay for food for himself and at least for his family. Three, there are some women who do these things to push you when they feel that you are lazy or when they feel that you're looking for a certain six-figure job. Looking for a certain job with prestige, you want to wear a suit, you want to wear a tie, you want to have that form of respect as a big dog in the industry and all of that. So sometimes these women do things like this to push you. It's unfortunate. It feels unfortunate. But then when you called your wife to tell your wife that things are hard in Saudi Arabia, the fact that she asked you to come to Ghana was that, for me, I feel that there's a little bit of belief in you. And there's a little bit of like, you know what, you don't need to go to Saudi Arabia. I'm sure she probably told you that, look, my guy, my husband, you can make it in Ghana. You don't need to go to Saudi Arabia. But you felt that somebody told you that amassing like X number of thousand cities go to Saudi Arabia to do X, Y, Z to probably guarantee you that kind of job. Now you've gone now, then you've come back. But you see, some women see beyond what you feel, like they see the potential, but they feel that unless they do something drastic, you will not be able to unearth that potential. Somebody said that in every adversity, there's a seed of equivalent advantage. So these hard times should propel you to want to do something to supply for your family and not to be morbid about your wife left me and my wife left me and I can't provide. No, what are you doing about it? You have 2 months to pay your rent. Look, I don't think that any well-meaning woman who hasn't divorced you yet, who has not, you know, maybe she's doing all these things to kind of propel you, or even if she's not doing it to do that, these things that she's doing, how unfortunate it should be, should actually propel you to do something about yourself, to make yourself better. Now, getting a job, you see, when you say that I'm getting a job, it's like you're going applying. But you see, even in this COVID times, some people are making money in this COVID times, whilst others are losing their jobs. Some are actually thankful for COVID. Look, most of the dressmakers who are making masks, this local mask and all those things, I'm sure they are thanking God for COVID silently. Because in this COVID times, they are selling so many masks, they are selling all kinds of things, and they are profiteering out of it. Those who can make sanitizers, they are selling so many of it, and they're profiteering out of it. Sometimes you just need to look into your inner self. And I have a problem. If you've been working, you're a good person, I'm surprised that for so long you couldn't get anybody to help you. Sometimes these things happen and it's difficult to get help. But when you are somebody with a good heart, you are somebody who's helped people, some way, somehow, when you're falling, there's always that miracle that comes from nowhere. That's because you are somebody with a good heart. And then if whatever you say, whatever God you say, whatever you believe in, if you are faithful to that particular supreme being, there's always this thing that happens in the 11th hour that sorts you out. But you can't benefit from that sorting out if you are morbid for yourself, if you find self-pity in yourself, if you are so low in yourself. There has to be, look, even if somebody wants to hand you something freely, you need to extend that hand to collect it. So there's a part of you that needs to put in some kind of effort in trying to do something for yourself. And trust me, nothing is so little or nothing is too little. At this point in time, if your wife is cheating on you, left, right, and center, but your responsibility towards your children, the need for your children to see you and go like my father looked after us, should propel you to something greater. And if you look at the positives, the fact that you still have life, the fact that you are still healthy, the fact that you are strong, you still have a brain in your head, use all those things to your advantage to get out of the situation that you're in. And then hopefully, slowly, it won't be overnight. You would make, like Tina said, you will make all that big money overnight. But you need to start from somewhere. And starting from somewhere doesn't always mean applying for a job and getting that appointment letter to work for somebody. Sometimes it means looking into yourself, looking at what you're capable of doing, what service you could sell to somebody for some extra money. And then you make that money, and who knows? You can have a job, you can now become an entrepreneur out of all these circumstances. So sometimes, there are so many times I've been in situations that I thought that I was at rock bottom, and then you think of something unusual, and then it takes you out of that rock bottom. So hey, just look at the positive. It's a bit unfortunate. And for me, if your wife was just pushing you, that's okay. But the cheating bit is what gets to me, because I don't think anybody, man or woman, deserves that kind of treatment, because marriage is actually for better or worse. So far as you're interested in marriage and you're still in it, you need to be faithful to your spouse. You need to show good faith to your spouse. I think cheating is not. And it's unfortunate that your wife will cheat on you at this time. But I think that all those energies propel it for good. And in no time, your wife will probably come begging you and apologizing for all her ills. And then your message next time will be whether you should forgive her or not. And we'll address that.
Okay. Right. Olivia, do you have any other thoughts where this is concerned?
Yeah. Gentlemen, first and foremost, I'd like to advise you, please do not kill yourself. Do not kill yourself. I know it feels terrible right now. I know things feel, you feel terrible right now, but there's no solution in you killing yourself. Okay, so that's just by the by. Latina said, we will try as much as possible to give you any help with regards to counseling, but please let death be the last thing on your mind right now, and let's look at how we can resolve the situation. So you used to be a businessman. That's something you used to do. Things are going on great, but now things are bad. You've tried all sorts of things to remedy the situation, to take charge of your family. It didn't work. Friends and family used to help you, but now they're tired of you probably begging and asking. Sweethearts, listen, with regards to marriage, things are usually not clear and dry. They're not cut and dry, or they're not straightforward. There's always ups and downs. There's times when things are very rosy. There's times when things aren't as rosy. There's times when things are very crazy. I mean, I'll talk out of experience. There were times in our marriage whereby my hubby lost his job. Things were crazy. Like, I'm not even cooking up stories, but things do happen. And what happened, my God, what do I do? Or what did I do? I was very supportive of my husband. It hadn't had to happen that at some point in time, you know, things are up and down. Or that's life for you. And I think your hurt and your pain is coming from the fact that it's gone on for too long. You've tried to solve the problem. You've gone through even extreme measures of finding money from wherever you have to find money from to go to Saudi Arabia so that you would give your wife, you know, and your children what they deserve. You're a good man. And I mean, I'd like to also use this opportunity to reach out to young women out there and to married couples. When things are not right for the men, can we please be supportive? Especially when the man is not lazy, especially when it's obvious that he's trying so hard to help the family. You know, I know there's my husband's mechanic was recently telling him that, you know, he works at Buskine, right? And now with COVID and everything that's happening, he can't be able to give money to his wife like he used to. Meanwhile, when things were going well and he was selling spare parts at Botokai and he was also doing his mechanic job, when he got money, he set his wife up to sell cocoa. He set his wife up to do her business, to sell cocoa, bofrot and all of that. Now that things are crazy and we can't import things or something, now there's so many things happening. Basically, money isn't coming as it used to. The wife has become very disrespectful. She's become very defiant. I mean, it got to a point in time whereby she insulted him and he got angry and he slapped her. You know, not that he slapped her. Mm. And he was wondering that, like, you know, understand now I'm being. And he felt so bad for doing that. He called my husband on the phone. He didn't know what to do. They called family members into the whole situation. They tried to resolve the situation. So the wife came back home. She got upset, went out. She came back home. Now she's been disrespectful the whole time. I'm just saying that situations whereby the women will not even want to pay for salt to put in food for the kids to eat because the husband doesn't have a job. I mean, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. If he was doing what he had to do when he had, why can't you just shut up? Support if you're working. It won't kill you. Help the man and his pride and his ego. You can see that he's trying his very best. And support in prayer and in finances. It's not going to be forever. It's just the face of life. Mm. It's just the face. It will pass. And I get so passionate about things like this because I hear all sorts of stories all the time. And I'm wondering, we as women, what is our role? You know, we can't just sit down and think that, oh, maybe Mistika man or Debeka or, you know, go and be in another relationship with another man. Or like, it's enough. And truth be told, we are in a time whereby things are crazy. Okay, so young man, moving on. Listen, you can start with little things. Huh? You can start by selling coconuts by the streets. You don't have to look for something big to do. Start by selling coconuts. You can start by selling eggs. You can start by little things. And by the time you realize and you pray on it, you move, you pray, you fast. I serve a living God who answers prayers, who makes miracles happen. Mm. Okay? People think he's a God of 19 so-so, but trust me, miracles, God does make miracles happen. When you go on your knees and you pray and you ask God to help you, this is what you're doing. God says he'll bless the work of your hands, and he will. Start with little things. With the situation regarding your rent, yeah? Right now, the last thing you want to do is to be accruing debt. And thankfully, your wife is no longer in the house. Your children have left, so you don't have to carry that burden. It is what it is. She's gone, so at least you don't have to deal with that. With regards to the rent, this is what I think. If you have parents who are still alive and they have a house or somewhere that you can go and pitch for a while, leave the rent. Don't pay rent. Go and stay with your parents. Stay with your parents. Gather yourself together. Sell eggs. Do something. Get some money. Save. Start up and pray on it every day at a time. You get a little money. You save. You pray. You start from somewhere and ask God to turn things around. And I believe from that things turn around. And for the woman who cheated on you, I mean, shame on her. I mean, I salute you. This is a situation whereby even before you went to Saudi Arabia, you knew your wife cheated. But, you know, you decided to forgive her. It means that you understand her, even though you shouldn't. You actually understand him, and good for you. So, my dear sweetheart, don't give up. It is not, and I want you to look at things this way. It could have been worse. Okay, it could have been worse. As worse as it may seem today, it could always have been worse. So try and encourage yourself. Okay, go to now there are so many Sankwa churches and stuff around, so be mindful of the kind of church that you go to. Take the Bible, read, spend time with God. I mean, I believe strongly that this situation will turn around for your good. Everything that God probably wants you to learn out of this situation, which is definitely not permanent, you will learn and you'll become a better, bigger man. Mm. And trust me, a time will come here where your wife will look at you and she will be so disappointed that she did what she did to you.
Right.
And that is where you turn around and give praise and glory to God. So that's my little advice. Keep going. It will work out for you.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. A lot has been said. I don't think I need to add on to this one, but the most difficult position to be in is when you're at your lowest and the person who claims to love you just abandons you. Like, that's, I'm so sorry about what you're going through. Certainly, suicide is not the answer. Just listen to what the sisters have said, you know. And sometimes out of desperation, some of the best ideas are born, you know. So look around you. Look, I mean, with, for instance, Corona in our lives today, there's so many problems that need to be solved. See, which identify a problem and offer solutions, and you'll be surprised that that will become your cash cow. Okay, so we wish you the best of luck. Thank you so much for watching Sister Sister on your favorite City TV. Now, don't forget, if you want some more exciting content, you can always subscribe to our YouTube channel. We call it the City Tube. And don't forget to click on the bell to receive notifications for fresh updates. Sister Sister, every Friday at 9 p.m., only on City TV.